In this video, I will show you 6 important JavaScript array methods. Filter. The filter method gives you back a new array containing those values that passed a test, and that test is contained in the function that you pass in. So we have a look at even numbers. We're using the filter method, and then we're passing in a function, and we're checking for modulo. So modulo 2, what is that? Well, let's have a look at that line return. Return number, and then the percentage sign, which is the modulo operator 2, and strictly equals 0. So what we're seeing here is, please give me back numbers that are dividable through 2, that means that 0 is left over. And if we have a look at our array, our numbers array, from all those numbers there, the only ones that are put in that new even numbers array are 4 and 10, because those are the only numbers that when you divide them through 2, you get back 0. So, with other words, you can use modulo to check for even numbers. And that's what we're doing here in conjunction with our filter method. We're using this to get a new array with even numbers. Now, below that, you see even numbers 2, so a second example. And here I've used the arrow function. So this is a newer way how we can write functions, and you see number and then the arrow, number again, and so that would be the block that we see in the upper one with that return number. That is the equivalent, and number, the first time number, so on the left side of the arrow, that is our parameter, which on the top example comes right after function and then brackets number. So these are just 2 different ways to write or to use the same filter method. Sort. The sort method sorts the elements of an array in place and gives you back the reference to that very same array. So as we see here in the example, we have our names array, and then we use the sort method directly on it. So we're not creating a new array. We could, but we're not creating a new array because this sort method is going to actually sort the values of our array in place. So from now on, names, the element, will start with Adam, and the last one will be Zach. Find. The find method gives you back an element out of an array that passes a specific test that you've provided. Now, in this case, again, we have our numbers array, and we see that if we use the find method on it, again, we have to provide the test. What are we testing for? Just like we did in the filter method section, we're looking for an even number. So we're using modulo 2, and whatever is has the output value of 0 from that modulo test will be an even number. But this time we're only getting back one element, 4, because the find method gives you back the very first element of that array that passes that test and nothing else. And by the way, just so that you see, the second example is the exact same find method, but this time also written with the arrow function. Includes. The include method determines if an array contains a certain element, and if it does, it gives you back the value of true. If it doesn't, it gives you back the value of false. That's what we see here with names. We're checking for, does it include Zach? It gives it back the return value of true. And then we're checking for something interesting, for a small a, because as you see, a couple of those names contain that character. But in this case, it gives us back the value of false. So that lets us understand that it's searching for that exact value, Zach, and then it will give us back true. Now, maybe, what do you think? What will happen if we would have 2 Zachs in this array? What would it give us back? Let us know in the comments section below. Would it give us back true or false or maybe something else? Slice. The slice array gives you back a new array containing a portion of the original array as you have defined. The slice method can take no parameters at all, or it can take two, where the first is the start and the second is the end. Here are a couple of examples to walk us through. In the first example, we see that on our months array, which by the way contains an abbreviation of all of the actual 12 months in a year, we're using the slice method and we're passing in one parameter, the number 9. Now that will be interpreted as the start parameter, meaning that it will give us back a new array beginning at index 9. So that's why it gives us October, November, December. You remember arrays start with index 0. So in this case, January is 0, and that is why index 9 is October, and not what we would expect 10, as in the month of October being the 10th month. Now, on to the next example, last two. Here we're saying months, and we're using the slice method on it, and we're using minus 2, meaning that we will be beginning at the end. And that's why we will get back a new array containing November and December, because minus 2 means the last two elements of the array. Then we're singling out the month of February by using the slice method on our array and saying, okay, start at index 1, makes sense, February's index 1, and end at index 2. And this is where it might get a little bit weird, because you're thinking, well, wait a minute, index 2 is March, so why are we only getting back February? Well, the end parameter in the slice method omits the end, meaning that 1, start, and 2 will give us back index 1. So this might be a little bit confusing when you first see it. Then on to the first quarter. Here we're saying, give me back from index 0 till 3. And again, 3 would be April in our case, but we're getting January, February, March in our new array because the index 3 is omitted. And just to show you, you can use the slice method without any parameters. In that case, you just get a new array that contains all of the elements from the original array. Splice. The splice method changes the existing array by, for example, removing, adding, or simply changing existing elements. And again, the splice method takes in a couple of different parameters, and they all do something specifically. So let's have a look at the first example where we're using the splice method on our months array, and we're passing in 2. So the first parameter starts for the index of our array. So 2 in that case would be January is 0, February is 1, and April in that case is 2. So April. And then we're saying 0. 0 stands for don't delete anything. So that second parameter that we're using here stands for how many elements of the array do you want to delete? In our case, none. So you kind of can imagine that our cursor in the array is standing there at April. And then we're saying March. We're passing in MAR, standing for March. So we're saying we're at April, now add March to it, which means that April kind of gets pushed to the right side, and now we have March there. And you see below, I'm trying to show with this output value, we're changing that array. We're not creating a new array, we're changing that existing array, meaning that now March is there between February and April. On to the next example, where we're saying splice minus 1. You remember, whenever you use index minus 1 in an array, it means you're starting at the end. So minus 1, and then the second parameter we're passing in is 1, meaning please delete one element. And that's why we get back our array, but only containing one May. Because if you look at the original array, we have 2 months of May in there, and we got rid of that. Now on to the very last example, We're using splice with 0 meaning begin at index 0, 1 meaning delete, so Jan is now gone, and then we're adding the new element that we would like to add to that specific place in the array, so at the very beginning, and that is the string of this is January. Okay, so very important to keep in mind, the first parameter stands for where in the array to start. The second one stands for, do you want to delete something? Use 0 if you don't, 1 if you do. And the third, if you want to, is the new item that you're going to add. Now, there's something special to keep in mind, being that the delete, or 0, 1, this parameter can be omitted, but not if you're going to add a new item. So months.splice.2,0,mart, I had to write that like that. I couldn't have written 2 and just simply march to add a new one. In this specific case, I have to say, don't delete anything, but please add this. Please let me know in the comments section below, which of these methods do you find the most intriguing, interesting, or maybe difficult to wrap your head around? And by the way, since array has so many methods and we tend to work a lot with arrays in JavaScript, the next video is also going to be about even more array methods, so part number 3, and to not miss out on that, I suggest you hit that subscribe button so that you, by the way, don't miss out on any of our other JavaScript videos that we publish on this channel.